Hi guys, are you considering a move to the North Raleigh or Wake Forest area? Then you definitely need to be aware of some things that might affect you when relocating here. By being aware of these issues before relocating, you can potentially avoid some serious headaches once you're already living in the area. In this video, I'm going to discuss what I consider to be the top 5 tips you should know before moving to the area. And we're going to get started right now. Hi guys, I'm Mike Sanders with the Mike Sanders team at RE/MAX United in Raleigh. Okay, stick with me guys, not each of these 5 tips are going to affect each and every one of you, but I'm willing to bet at least a couple of these are going to affect you. Be sure you stay until the end of the video because my last tip alone could potentially save you from a moving day nightmare scenario that, trust me, you don't want to be any part of. Okay guys, without further ado, here in no particular order are my top 5 tips you need to know about before moving to the North Raleigh or Wake Forest area. Tip number 1, check local school caps. Guys, if you've got kids and you're contemplating a move to the area, you need to be aware that due to school-wide system growth, some Wake County schools have implemented enrollment caps. For example, I get a lot of buyers who are specifically interested in the Wake Forest area, in part due to the excellent schools here, such as the schools located within the Heritage Wake Forest community. Well, if this describes you, then you need to be aware that Heritage High School, as of the production date of this video, currently has an enrollment cap on new student admissions that might affect your child's eligibility getting into one of your desired schools. You might be wondering where your child will attend school if the nearby neighborhood school where you want to move has capped enrollment. Well, once a school reaches its maximum enrollment number, new families who move into the base attendance area will instead be assigned to an overflow school. If the base school eventually increases its enrollment along with its cap limit, your child might then be eligible to move from the overflow school into their base school. However, you need to be aware that your base school, which typically is the closest one to your neighborhood, might not ever open up. You need to make sure that if you're contemplating a home purchase, that you're okay with this. Tip number 2, investigate temporary housing options well in advance of your desired move-in date. If you need to rent before you purchase a home, make absolutely sure you check around the local area well in advance of your move to check on rental availability. In this area, over the last several years, we've not only had a shortage of new home inventory, but this home shortage has helped exacerbate a shortage of apartment inventory. This has caused apartments to become somewhat difficult to find, but it's also caused apartment rates to increase at a pretty hefty rate. For example, a 3-bedroom, 2-bath apartment in the Wake Forest area is going to cost you anywhere between $1,300 all the way up to potentially $3,000 or more, depending on the location and the amenities. Keep in mind that you can also rent a single-family detached home for comparable rates. But again, available rentals of all kinds can take some time to locate. Just don't wait until the last minute. Keep in mind that between June 2020 and June 2021, a recent study by the Triangle Business Journal found that typical rental rates in the Raleigh market rose 10.2%, which is in part a reflection of supply and demand issues affecting the local rental market. Tip number 3, arrange childcare needs well in advance. If you have small kids who will need childcare, then this next tip is going to be really huge. Right now in the North Raleigh Wake Forest area, there's a real shortage of childcare options. If you're contemplating a move to the area and you need childcare, you could potentially be looking at anywhere between 1 and 6 months for a spot to open up for your child, depending on your budget, their age, and your desired level of care. Depending on your needs, your weekly childcare expenses can typically range anywhere between $300 to $375 per week. Most of your franchise or national chain providers are going to include some level of educational curriculum for this weekly fee, along with meals and diapers if you have really young ones. Just make absolutely sure that you check out childcare options well ahead of your move so you don't find yourselves in a serious bind once you get here. There are many independent mom and pop daycare businesses that can be found throughout the area as well, which can often be found charging less than this $300 per week fee. Just keep in mind that most of these providers aren't going to provide much more than basic babysitting services and won't typically offer much in the range of educational opportunities. Tip number 4, high-speed internet availability. With many more people working from home these days, one of the things that many people are searching for is really good high-speed internet service, preferably at speeds of 1,000 megabytes per second, or what's more commonly referred to as 1 gigabyte speed. Well, if you're moving to the Wake Forest area, then you're in luck because there are several local internet providers who offer ultra-fast internet speed. One of my favorites that I happen to have at my home is Ting Internet, which is one of the newest entrants to the Wake Forest market. Keep in mind that not each neighborhood in the area is going to be serviced with gigabit speed, so you'll want to do your own research before moving moving to the area if the internet speed is important to you. One really neat tool that you can use to find out whether a specific area you're considering has high-speed internet options is the website highspeedinternet.com. Here you can input a zip code and find out which providers offer service. Just keep in mind that you'll want to contact each provider individually to find out if they offer service to a specific neighborhood, since coverage can vary by address. Tip number 5, checking out the availability of new home appliances. If your relocation involves the purchase of new home appliances, then you may have second thoughts about getting rid of your old ones when you discover that there are currently severe supply chain issues involving new appliances. Ever since the onset of COVID-19, the entire manufacturing industry, including appliance manufacturers, has been greatly affected, with significantly increased demand for home appliances due in part to COVID-19, but also due to increased home production that affects the availability of appliances. The most heavily in-demand items right now that are on back order involve ovens, refrigerators, and dishwashers, which are now sometimes taking several months to make it to consumers. One factor affecting appliance production is the unavailability of parts manufactured in Mexican factories that were shut down for several months due to local COVID outbreaks. I'm actually currently recommending to my seller clients for them to seriously consider keeping their major appliances like refrigerators and washers and dryers instead of conveying them over to new buyers of their homes, since repurchasing these appliances later on might be an issue. Okay guys, now for my bonus tip. This involves moving company. Depending on where you're relocating from, you could potentially have a longer wait scheduling a moving company to move your belongings. Typically, moving companies are going to need about a 2-week advance notice of your desired move date. However, this can vary from city to city. If you happen to live in a state with high levels of outbound moving, like California, New York, or New Jersey, you probably want to start lining up moving companies well in advance of 2 weeks. And guys, this is huge. Also, make absolutely certain that you keep in contact with your moving company on a consistent basis with increased regularity leading up to your move date. I've heard horror stories where people relocating hired moving companies who not only didn't bother to show up on the day of their scheduled move, but who were impossible to contact after not bothering to show up. By keeping in touch prior to your move day, you can help lessen the odds of this happening to you. If you happen to be a home seller in the Raleigh-Wake Forest area, give me a call, because I have several go-to companies that are nothing short of fantastic. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching and checking out my channel. I really appreciate it. If you would, please subscribe and hit me with a thumbs up. And whatever you do, get Mike and get moved.